So now it is live streaming. Right now.
And some sound bites.
See, now there's nobody here yet.
Okay.
In a few seconds, we should get some people. The connection isn't so great, nice. So we'll see. So here we go.
Oh, nice.
Here we got some people watching. I am here with my friend, Eric Clymer. Say hi, Eric.
Nice to meet everybody.
He is an Austin native, and I'm here visiting. See, we got 17 people watching already here. So it sends out messages to everybody on my Twitter feed. And then they click over and join us. And so now we've got people who are commenting. So we've got a few people liking. And every time they like or retweet, it goes out to their Twitter feed and people can join the conversation. We got 41 people so far watching. And so I've been doing this every day just to give a little debrief of what I'm doing, what I'm thinking, what's going on in the tech world. So, and then people, you know, can just ask a question every once in a while. So like this morning, for example, I might share that I went out to breakfast with a buddy of mine. Last night I had a talk around the hook model, and now we're going out to lunch and we're eating
Some Black's Barbecue at Rocket Mobile. What up, everybody? To the women watching, I'm single. Nice to meet you.
He's doing a plug here. I love
Absolutely.
It. tell us about what you're working on, Eric, because you are a startup entrepreneur. You're building a new product. What can you share with us about what you're building and how you're making it habit forming?
I love it. I love the. Ooh, I'm avoiding potholes, so this will be like a real-time interview. Let's do it.
Let's do it.
I'm Eric. We're working on this new app that should be out in May. We actually read Nir's book Hooked as a team back in June. We found it really informative to our design process. I think read it in three parts, and essentially what we wanted to do was use a lot of Nir's tricks. Tricks might be too small a word. I feel like a lot of what Nir adds is really valuable because
And by the way, you don't have to give me compliments.
No.
I appreciate it, but I didn't pay him to say this.
Yeah, that's totally true.
Maybe I should pay him to say
this. Yeah, we'll work that out after. Anyways, we found the book really valuable, and really what we wanted to do was understand why we like the apps we like. I think that's a good way to describe kind of what Nir sets out to do. And so as we built the messaging product that we're going to launch here in probably late May, we wanted to make sure everyone would like it as we do, using it within the office. You know, we'll be in beta soon, but we're still using it internally. So anyways, more on that later. Eric S. Clymer on Twitter if you want to follow.
Cool.
Nice to meet everybody.
Yeah, so it's always awesome to hear people using the hook model. I actually talked with the CEO of Meerkat. Meerkat launched about, 9 days ago?
Great logo, by the way.
Yeah, it's a really cool logo. Yeah. And it's interesting because their product was completely different at first. They were doing this live streaming, which has been tried 100 times before, but it wasn't really working. And then they launched this little side effort, and they figured out this, what I think their real advantage was two things. Number one, the virality that they get through Twitter is unbelievable. So every time I start this live stream, it goes out to my Twitter feed, and if you have, you know, a few thousand people following you, you're going to get people watching. Even though this idea has been done so many times, right? There was Quick, there's a company called Ustream, which has something similar, but this company really kind of lit up last week because of that viral channel. Even though it's interesting, because the reason they wanted to do this whole pushing it out to Twitter strategy was that they wanted to have this instant reward in the reward phase of the hook of when I start live streaming, I need feedback, like right away. And that's exactly what happened. You saw in seconds, now 56 people are watching, but in seconds you get that feedback, which is amazing, from this very simple action of just scheduling or starting that live stream. And the second thing they do really well is that this is ephemeral. So it's got this like Snapchat quality of, we can talk about whatever we want. I don't have to filter myself. I don't really have to care how I look because it's gone.
Oh, right? Nice.
I can save the stream, but I don't have to save the stream.
Question about ephemerality.
Yeah.
Do you feel like that's something that, aside from Snapchat, the world wants, the world expects? It's something we are debating in our own product that we're going to launch. Is ephemerality a feature or something that someone expects to be simply a setting at this point?
So that's a good question. I think it works. This is why I think the using a model, whether it's the hook model or somebody else's model, this is why I think using a model is so important. It has to fit into a strategy.
Okay.
We can't say that like that ephemerality is that even a word?
It should be a word today. This is ephemeral, so it's a word today.
All right, it's a word. So I think the reason it works on Snapchat is because people do a lot of flirting on Snapchat.
And yeah, so, me included, again.
Right, exactly.
For all the single women.
Right, and so it works because it shifts people down the ability curve.
Okay.
Right, so like all of a sudden, all this thinking I had to do about, oh, how do I look and what do I say? And, you know, there's a lot of barriers to sharing when you're really concerned about these problems around, like, who's going to see what I do. So Snapchat, you know, it's critical to a product like Snapchat because the alternative, like the habit they were breaking, was Facebook. And so if I'm thinking, am I going to share on Facebook versus sharing on Snapchat, I'm much more likely to share on Snapchat because it's gone. So it increases my ability to share, and that's exactly what this does. I would never be doing this if I knew this was going straight to YouTube,
right,
and everybody could see it forever and ever.
Record.
Right, but the fact that, like, I can broadcast, I can say whatever I want, maybe I'm wrong, maybe I'm right, but I can share ideas in this format, and I know it's gone, makes me more likely to actually do it, because it's gone, right? So, sure is. All right, thanks for helping me there. By the way, who's
here? That's pretty cool.
What I also like about it, I can click on people who are here, and so if I recognize some friends, like here's John, and Guy is here, so Alex, thanks for showing up, everybody, and thanks for the love and retweeting. This is really nice of you to share this. You want to take some questions?
Yeah, for sure.
Hey, anybody have any questions about the hook, about habit-forming products, about South By? About tacos, perhaps.
About why you should be nice to your college friends. College and I went.
Yes.
Nir and I went to college together.
Yes. Eric and I were in the same fraternity. Can you believe that?
In hindsight, it's bizarre to call it a fraternity.
Why?
But we were. Oh, I mean, it was just a good group of dudes. Like, I think when people think fraternity, they think, you know, backwards hats and neon sunglasses. And I think we were that group of guys.
There was a little bit of that.
Just a few.
Yeah, there was a little bit of that. But it was a good time. Let's see. Any other questions here?
So do they tweet at you for questions? Is that
so they can push this little comment button and ask a question. And sometimes people do, sometimes people don't. There's always a little bit of a lag too. So there's a lot that they can improve with this app. I'm not calling Meerkat as the next Twitter. I think it is highly habit forming. They've got a great hook. The CEO was telling me about his hook, and I think they've definitely nailed a hook. Mm-hmm. Now we know, you know, having a hook and having an engaging product is just one out of three things you have to nail. You also have to have growth. You have to have monetization. So we're still waiting to see if that can sustain itself. But I think they've got a damn good start at it. Here we go. Snapchat-ish feel. Yeah, this definitely has a Snapchat feel. I think the ephemerality definitely is a plus. What's the name of Eric's company?
We're called Rocket Mobile. The app we're working on is called Time Bomb. If you go to rocketmobile.com, you'll see a little bit about us. More on Time Bomb in a month. It's kind of Time Bomb for Time Bomb is what I like to say.
All right, cool. And they want to know how you're actually deploying the hook method. Can you share the hook with us,
Jim? Yeah, sure. Not to say anything negative about a massive incumbent. One of the things we feel like Snapchat missed a little bit is the idea that someone saw my snap. When I send it to somebody, you want to know somebody opened it, frankly. I know Instagram Direct does this.
Mm.
One of the things we're looking at is, like, I sent you something and it's really fun for me to know when you got it because that brings me back into the app. Perhaps we can have a conversation about something at that point. So that's just a simple example of one of the ways we wanted to make sure people invest more in the platform and get more out of it.
Hmm. All right. So when would you, what's the action you want people to take as much as you can share with us? What's the habit you want to create every time you what?
We think every time you send, without talking in the actual hook of the product, anytime, and I'm doing this while I'm driving, so bear with me.
Yeah.
Anytime someone sends a message, we think that they are more likely to send another message if someone views their message.
Hmm.
We think viewing a message means you are more likely to send a message yourself. I don't think that's anything groundbreaking there, but I think the action we want to take is in some way, anytime you enter the app and view someone's message, that it provides a feedback loop for whoever sent it, commented on it, liked it, etc. I know that's really abstract, but the idea that anytime you, snap, you send it into the world. I'm even going to try to change lanes here, people. This is like pro.
And who said multitasking doesn't work? You are multitasking.
Anytime you send a snap into the world, particularly a group one, it's on you to go back into the app and see who saw it. I understand why Snapchat does that. I'm not saying that was a mistake. That makes sense for their platform. I don't know that it makes sense for ours.
Yeah.
So we wanted to give people a reason to go back. We wanted to make a conversation amongst your friends, particularly around the hook we're developing, engaging and fun. We think if it's a fun product, that goes a long way.
So, you know, it's not that different. It's not that crazy. It's, I think, why messaging apps have their fundamental hook of, you know, the external trigger is when you get a message on Message Me or WhatsApp or the Facebook Messenger, when you see the message, the action is to open the app. The variable reward, it's what's in the message.
Sure.
Right? There's a variability of the social reinforcement, rewards of the tribe around what's actually in the message. And then the investment is just to reply.
Yep.
And so what you're saying is that if we can make that reply process as easy as possible, that investing in the platform, right, there's no immediate reward to sending a reply. There's usually a lag, right, of getting a reply back. But of course, when you send that reply, you're going to get this external trigger that brings you through the app once again, because you're going to get that notification that provides the next external trigger to not only you, but everybody else who's in that group message.
Who was part of the conversation.
Right. Let's take some more questions here. What's a good hook for donating? You mean for charity? Love. This is from, for a donating app. So, you know, I get a lot of around charity and apps that have these altruistic purposes. It's not easy, you know, because donating should not be the action. You can't make a habit out of somebody giving money. So I always advise, don't make the hardest part the action phase. The action phase should be, it is defined as the simplest behavior in anticipation of reward. So opening the app, or just, you know, logging in, or scrolling, or pushing the play button, those are actions. Giving money is not an action. Giving money is an investment. And so monetization is a result of engagement. Way too many apps and products try and get people to do really hard things way too soon. And so particularly in like charity space and products that help people live better lives and do altruistic things, the monetization has to be a result of engagement, a result of the habit. Don't ask for it upfront. It has to be something that comes later. All right, so we are here. We arrived at our destination at Eric's office where we're going to have a super secret meeting about his new product.
Mainly just barbecue.
Right, mainly barbecue. That's true. Thanks for everyone tuning in, all 87 of you. Thanks so much for tuning in. And I will do this later in the day or maybe tomorrow. Thanks again.
Nice to meet everybody.
Bye-bye.